guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome to my channel. Welcome to another day of Vlogmas. If you are new, I have been uploading videos every single day and I'm going to be doing that every single day until Christmas. Make sure you guys subscribe and you guys can go binge all those videos. But for today's video, I've been wanting to do this video for a while now. This is going to be like a 6-month post-op rhinoplasty update and answering your guys' questions. If you are new or you don't know, I got my rhinoplasty June 29th, I believe, this year, and I literally vlogged everything. I vlogged my whole experience. I will link that down below. And then after, I think like a month later, I posted like a Q&A about it. I was still super swollen in that video, but I will link that down below as well, and I answered your guys' questions. But since then, I've gotten a lot of really good feedback on that video, so thank you guys so much. Big shout out to you guys. And I've gotten tons and tons of DMs asking like questions. Who would I go to? How much was it? I vlogged literally before I got my surgery, like right before I got my surgery, and then right after I got out of surgery, and then I vlogged my whole recovery experience, which is really nice and very helpful. Obviously to you guys have been really liking that video, so thank you guys so much. Without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and get into this video because I feel like I'm talking way too much. Okay, so I got my rhinoplasty. Basically, if you are new, I had a really big, it's called a dorsal hump. I had a really big bump on my nose. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull up a picture. It's really embarrassing, actually. What bothered me about it most is that it wasn't genetic. What happened was I wore glasses since I was 2 years old up to literally me getting my rhinoplasty, 18 years, you guys. Seriously, like, basically my whole life, I wore glasses. And so, since I was wearing glasses so long, the glasses kind of created a bump, like a seat for themselves on my nose, and that's why I never, like, switched to contacts, because I was so insecure about it, and I knew I always wanted to get a rhinoplasty. And so once I did, I was so happy, and I'm really excited to answer your guys' questions, show you guys what it looks like right now, and 6 months after. And so yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get into your guys' questions. So the number one question I have been getting asked is, who is the doctor I went to? I mentioned that I went to TJ. I went to Mexico to get my rhinoplasty because here it's very, very expensive. The messages you guys have been sending me, a lot of you guys wanna go to Mexico as well, and you guys want a doctor. This is his Instagram, and his website will be linked down below for you guys. That is the surgeon I went with. I 100,000% recommend. Guys, he is 100% fluent in English, so if you guys are worried about that, I know I'm not like an expert at Spanish. I do understand a lot, most of it, but I can't like speak it fluently, so it was really helpful that he spoke English, and obviously he speaks Spanish as well. Someone also asked me, once I contacted my doctor, how long it took for him to respond. And I sent them an email. You basically contact them, and I got a response within a few days. And then I scheduled consultation right away. Another question I got was, did I do a virtual consultation? I did not. COVID was still a thing, obviously, but it wasn't like at right now. We're in like the purple tier, and like we're at stay-at-home orders and stuff, so I'm not sure how he does it right now. But no, I did not do a virtual consultation. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and get into the Instagram questions that you guys had. So the first one is, do you still feel pain? No, but kind of a little bit. No, it's hard to explain. It's been 6 months. I'm not in any pain like at all, but once in a while I will feel like a little bit sore, kind of like in between my nostrils, or like a little bit sore here every once in a while. A rhinoplasty does take a year to fully heal, and I'm planning to, when I hit my year mark, to update you guys once again and do like a full on experience, because I can't really give you guys like my whole experience because I'm not done recovering still. Yeah, so once in a while maybe, but other than that, it really doesn't hurt at all. The pros and cons now. The pros, obviously, I really like my side profile, and it's literally like boosted my confidence 1,000%. Like, it's so hard to explain. Like, I wanted this surgery so bad, literally for years, and so it's boosted my confidence a lot. Cons, there's not really any cons. I'm just more cautious because I'm still recovering about, like, you know, doing certain activities, or like, I don't know. There's really no other cons. I'm more cautious of myself because I'm not fully done recovering. I don't want to mess anything up. So yeah, but that's everything. Do you regret doing it? 1,000% no. I would do it again tonight. I really would. And I mean that like from the bottom of my heart. I would really do it again tonight. It was actually one of the best decisions that I've ever made, and I'm really, really happy. And I'm happy that I went with the doctor I went with. How long did it take for the swelling to go away? So if you guys, I will put a screenshot or a picture and it is a little graphic. I feel like you will see like a little bit of blood, so if that's something you don't want to look at, just skip like a couple seconds later. But this is how I look like right after the day after surgery, I believe. I know, I look rough. You guys, literally, this is like the worst I ever looked. Clearly, but I'm saying like usually I see people like go from this, and then as the days go on, I've seen other people's vlogs, they get like puffier and puffier and puffier. This is the worst I looked the day after my surgery, and every day after that my swelling was starting to go down. It took about 2.5 weeks. My swelling went down, and then I think what took the longest honestly was once it's not pink and purple anymore, it's yellow. And so I had like yellow under my eyes, and I feel like maybe I can pull up a picture, I'm not sure. I do want to mention kind of with the pros and cons. The cons were right after surgery, like actually like a month after surgery. So once the swelling was all gone, I was like trying to do makeup and stuff, and it was very, very, very hard to do like my foundation. And I just used a beauty blender, and it was super hard. It was just extremely hard to do my makeup for like the first, I would say first 2 to 3 months. Every time I would get to my nose, it was just like a lot of pressure, and that did suck a lot. I remember that. How bad was the pain from a scale 1 to 10? Literally a 2. Like legit, for me and in my experience. I felt nothing at all. Even like starting from like them giving me anesthesia and stuff, like it was just like literally nothing. Once I got out of surgery, I was not in any pain at all. I was like, my parents will tell you guys that I was like, let me see my new nose, like pull out the camera, let me vlog. Like I was fine, no pain. I was extremely nauseous after surgery, like extremely nauseous, and I even threw up a little bit, but after that I was fine. And once I got home, I was in no pain, and I was also taking pain medicine on top of like that, so I was literally feeling nothing. So yeah, I felt nothing. The only thing was like when I was in my cast and I would like touch my tip, it would be like extremely sore for the first week, I would say, but that's obvious, you know. It was just a lot of pressure, but not so much any pain at all. Was it worth it, and how much did it cost? Like I said, it was 1000% worth it for me, and my parents will tell you literally the whole experience, and like the doctors, the nurses, the whole staff was extremely helpful. We literally loved them. And how much did it cost? Okay, this I definitely want to talk about. The surgery itself, what I paid with my doctor, obviously every single place is going to be different, you guys, so do not, you know, it's not like a accurate comparison. Every place is different, but what I paid for my rhinoplasty was $3,500. But they do not like tell you, you know, like the side fees. So basically I'm gonna get into that right now. Basically, what the $3,500 included was obviously the anesthesia, the surgery, you know, like the surgeon fees and stuff. It gave me like a little pill before I went into surgery that kind of like helped with anxiety and like calmed me down. That also included like the consultation, and then also the 3 post-op appointments right after surgery. So I had, I think, a 1 week post-op, I think I had a 2 week post-op, and then I had a 3 month post-op, and that was all included in that price. However, the additional fees that I did pay before I even got my surgery, you need to go through like tests. So basically I did a EKG, which is basically, you know, testing my heart and seeing if my heart can handle the surgery I'm about to go through. Then they do blood work just to make sure your blood is okay to go through the surgery. They're like making sure you are surgery ready. I think those tests were like $70. And then also my medication was additional, so I think I paid another $60 with the medication I had. But other than that, that is all, you know, the cost. Definitely do your research of the doctors. Make sure you look at their work. Definitely that's what I looked at, was their before and after photos on their website. I definitely trusted my doctor a lot, and I really recommend him. Now I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys my nose. This is what it looks like. I love my side profile now. The last thing I want to mention is that my doctor told me that once I got out of surgery that my nose was going to be very lifted up for a couple of months. And that was 1000% true. You guys can go back to my old videos, like right after surgery when I started posting again. My nose looks like a pig. I didn't realize it when I was actually in the moment, but looking back, I can see a huge difference. I will pull up like a picture or something. My nose is very, very, very much lifted. And as you can see, like from now, it's totally different. I did see like my nose change every single day. That is definitely what happens, you guys. It's still changing. It's gonna still change. 6 more months to go, but I think after 6 months it's 90% healed. So yeah, that was definitely something I was like, oh my gosh, when I'm looking back at it. I didn't realize it in the moment. I was all happy with my new nose and stuff, but I was very much swollen. But yeah, you just have to trust the process and trust, let your body heal, you know? Give yourself some time. It's not gonna look perfect after a month, you know? Even after 6 months, it's not gonna look perfect. But yeah, I think that's everything I have to talk about today. I am extremely happy with my rhinoplasty. It was definitely a crazy experience, but I'm so happy I went through it and I would go through it again tonight. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Follow me on all my social medias, they'll be right here. And if you guys, I know a lot of you guys have DM'd me on Instagram. If you guys feel more comfortable DMing me, I will 100% most likely reply. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys in tomorrow's video.